The kids on Patton Street would get together every day to play. Brody's dad suggested to them to play hide-and-seek. "But make sure you stay out of Grandpa Tink's yard," he said. The children knew that they were told to stay away from Professor Tink's house, but his yard had the best places to hide. Walter said that he would count first. He reminded the others not to cross the street. Jordan, Brody, and Carson did not listen. Walter counted to 10 while the others went to hide. "Ready or not, here I come," Walter shouted. Brody and Jordan heard a voice coming from Grandpa Tink's house. A pair of eyes peeked out from the open door. "Hello, children. The time has come for you to meet us," said the voice. Brody knew he was not to disturb his grandfather. However, they had to see who was talking to them from inside the house. A dark figure stood in the doorway. The children were too scared to say anything. All at once, they ran out of the house. Neither Brody nor Jordan looked for cars as they crossed the street. Carson was last, and he did not look for cars either. The driver of the car did not see Carson crossing. At the very last second, someone pushed Carson out of the way of the oncoming car. Carson could not believe his eyes. A stroller had saved him. "Thank you," said Carson. "You're welcome," replied the stroller. "I have been waiting for you for a long time, Carson," said the stroller. Carson was amazed to see a talking stroller. The stroller told Carson to hold on to his handles. As Carson grabbed the handles, magic happened. The stroller went from gray to red. "Wow, a red race car," shouted Carson. "Once a child touches the handles of a magic stroller, that stroller becomes like that child, and the child becomes the rightful owner," explained the stroller. "Professor Tink has created us. We are all waiting for our little drivers. We have been with the professor for many years. Today is an exciting day for us," said the stroller. When Professor Tinkerman was young, he came across a magic oil can. This magical creature became best friends with the professor, and he taught the professor many new things. It wasn't until years later, when the professor figured out how to make us, we became like his children. Professor worked very hard and said that one day children would come for us. When the stroller was finished his story, he said, "Let's go see the professor." Carson told the others what had happened. They went straight to the professor's house. They knocked and waited. Grandpa Tink opened the door and said, "We have been waiting a long time for you." One by one, the eyes came from behind the professor. It was an exciting time for all. Please visit us at our website, www.littledrivers.net, to purchase your little driver, or email us brian.cox@littledrivers.net.